everyone's lips are the same, everyone's lips are dry, scrub your lips. Scrub your boyfriend's lips, scrub your husband's lips, whatever. Scrub.
Sara, thank you so much for being here.
I'm so excited to be here. This is so much
fun. We're going to talk about your brand, Sara Happ. Mm-hmm. You are the founder. Mm-hmm. How did this all happen?
This all happened because 100 years ago, and by that I mean 15, mm-hmm. there were no lip scrubs on the market. And I'm a scrubber, body scrubber, you face scrubber.
But I was editing a video last night, okay. and I realized mm-hmm. that your lip scrub mm-hmm. is my most reoccurring product.
That is the most gigantic compliment because this girl has literally everything.
It's true. It
should always be a lip scrub. You should scrub daily. You should scrub daily. You should. You have to. Like, so I made the lip scrub in my kitchen 15 years ago because I Googled lip scrub to go try to buy one at, like, you know, a major retailer or anywhere. And there were no results. And I got chills. And I was like, wait.
You got chills?
I got chills because I was like, wait a minute. Wait. There's a scrub for my face, my hands, my body, my feet, everything. There isn't one for my lips. I can make this in my kitchen.
Did you get chills because you needed it or mm-hmm. because you were like, I'm onto something?
I'm onto something. I was like, wait, if it doesn't exist, I can make this. Yeah. And so it was like one of those like chills moments where you have an idea and you're like, oh my gosh, this doesn't exist for real. I can do this. Right. Chills. I wanted a lip scrub that did the job and tasted delicious and then gave me immediate results. I'm a lip nerd. Like, I study lips for a living. My whole team studies lips. My chemists are lip chemists. Mm. It's niche, but that's what they are. They study lips. We study lips. It's all I think about when I'm at work is lips. And how to solve your lip problems, okay? So everyone's lips are dry because it's the one part of your body, fun fact, that doesn't have sweat glands.
I just say to people, if you've never scrubbed your lips, yes. you don't know what your lips can feel like.
Yeah, we actually trademarked the lip expert.
You are the lip expert.
Because it's all I do. Someone was like, you've put in your 10,000 hours of lip study, so you should trademark the lip expert.
Yep.
So, yeah, that's all we do. It's really, like, we do one thing, and we do it perfectly, and that is lips. So we're going to scrub. So people ask how often you scrub your lips. Every single day. Cell turnover. Like every day. Your cell turnover happens daily, and it happens mostly at night. So I scrub my lips every morning. We use gloves in our office so that we don't have fingerprints on stuff. You can't touch stuff without gloves.
And you can kill people whenever you want.
So when I was making these in my kitchen, my whole house smelled like sugar, and it smelled like a bakery. So I began baking cupcakes because I needed to eat sugar. And then my girlfriends came over to help me make lip scrub when I started selling it online, and I would only pay them in cupcakes because I had no money.
Right.
So I'd be like, I'll bake you. Cupcakes. No, you won't.
Okay, so this is my before.
And you take a tiny amount, like this, the littler the better. You don't need a lot. And all you need is your finger and a tissue. I don't actually need a mirror, but we're going to use a mirror right now.
Yeah, I don't need a mirror.
Sloane does this all the time.
I know where my lips are.
It's so simple. That's the thing. Like, the lip scrub is so simple. And it smells like a cupcake and grapefruit in here.
It smells like when you just eat the icing part of the cupcake.
Which is the best part. Mm-hmm. So you scrub like
cupcakes
this.
Cupcakes are vehicles for icing.
Mm. And the grapeseed oil and jojoba oil just sinks into your skin. Grapeseed and jojoba are so good for that thin skin on your lips. And while you're doing it, the sugar crystals melt.
It feels unlike any other scrub I've ever used because a lot of scrubs are really harsh.
Yeah.
And it feels almost like painful, and you feel like you have to get through that pain to get the benefits.
No, nothing should hurt. Beauty should not hurt.
Right.
Beauty should not hurt. Your lips
this
should not
so
hurt.
This feels so nourishing as I'm doing it. It's so enjoyable.
It is so enjoyable. It's gratifying because you're taking away the dead skin. Also, dead skin makes your lips tight.
Mm-hmm. Is that why they look bigger after?
Look at this. She's not wearing lipstick. Why don't I wipe this away? She's not wearing lipstick. She's not wearing lip gloss. This is her God-given rosy pink lip color.
And they feel so soft.
Like a baby.
It's crazy. It's like sometimes I don't want any product on my lips for whatever reason.
Right.
And I don't have to after I scrub them if I don't feel like it in that moment. Because they are so soft.
Look at your lips are pinker than mine. I have lip envy.
No, they are not.
Nope.
They're just a different shade. Mine are just darker. Yours are more like a petal.
No, let's just be real. It's fine. So you've just scrubbed them and you've nourished them. The next thing we're going to do is the Sweet Clay Lip Mask. So you're going to use a little bit. Mm-hmm. Okay. I do this nightly. I don't do this in the morning because who has the time? Not me. I do this nightly. It's the consistency
this
of frosting.
This has saved me countless times. Mm.
It's so restorative. It goes on like frosting. You're going to look crazy. And when we do this on air at QVC, I repeat so much. This is not a lipstick. People, this is not a lip gloss. This is a lip mask.
Right, because if you wipe just tuned in, you would think, what is happening?
What is happening? You look nuts. So you're gonna look nuts. Slathered on your lips. It tastes like vanilla and mint.
You know?
No, no, no. Don't be dainty. Slathered on the way you'd slather frosting on a cake. Leave it on for like 2 minutes. It's bentonite clay and this ingredient called Sloane Series that we source from the Himalayas. And it just stays the consistency of frosting. It's not a mask that dries and then you like rinse it off. So all you need yet again is a tissue. Here's what we're gonna use next. We're gonna use our plumping primer.
Oh, the plumping primer next. Okay.
We're gonna use our plumping primer. Okay, so.
Can I say, the first time I used this, I was like, wait, do I need to put another layer on?
It doesn't sting. A lot of people that don't like to feel product on their lips use just this.
Because it looks like nothing besides almost like that smoothing filter.
Yeah.
Okay, like, wait, let me do a swatch of the highlighters. I always gravitate towards a more cool toned highlight.
Always.
Because I am so fair.
And a cool tone anything makes your face look brighter and for your sure by your lips, your teeth
look
whiter.
Golden.
So pretty.
Sarah, are you kidding me?
I'm not. I'm so serious.
The I'm lightest fully of the on light. Top of you right now. I'm sorry.
For sure. For sure. Always. Anyone can wear either. We made this. We made the lip illuminator because everyone, again, this is like beauty editors, everyone was hacking. They were putting their eyeshadow right around their lip line.
I put my highlight on my lips.
No,
so you have
don't.
To teach me. Okay, so teach me how to use this.
Okay, so there are several ways to use this. Okay, so the Sara Happ way, again, because I'm not a makeup artist, I just highlight my lip line. If you're awesome, you can contour. I don't know how to contour.
Sorry, I'm going to wait. Can I put this on other areas of my face?
So in our office, we all do this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm going to do that too.
So if you put it around your lips, you're giving yourself skincare for your lips.
I'm
so
someone's going
to use the pearl, and I'm using the golden.
What? Sarah!
I know.
Are you kidding?
I'm not.
How did you do this?
A lot of work. A lot. Ah! Look at that! How good! And then you do the bottom right here.
Right here?
Mm-hmm. You do your Cupid's bow. This is called your vermilion line. This is when you know I'm a big lip nerd.
I'm gonna put it on my
chin a little. Your vermilion line. Okay. Another little known fact is that if you use a dark color around your lip line, it makes your lips look fuller. So
I'm gonna put a little bit then of the, should I put the bronzer? Will that look crazy?
No, you can mix them too. Okay. So I'm doing the golden, Sloane is doing the pearl lip illuminizer.
No, I'm doing both.
Okay. And
because I want to do that trick that you just said.
So I go around my lip line. So you can also do this. You can also hack. So we're like, use skincare, don't use makeup. You're just gonna throw light around and it just opens everything up. So
can I
we
do
are
something really weird?
Yeah.
Like the weirdest thing to probably ever take place on here.
I'm here for it. I'm ready. What?
Just give me your hand. Can I kiss your hand so you can feel how soft my lips are?
That's amazing. This has never happened to me. Oh my God.
You're gonna freak out. My lips are the softest I've ever felt them.
Baby. And now we're going to use color. All right, so I'm wearing my uniform. This is the pink slip.
I'm going to do the red.
Blue-based pink that I wear every day. Every day. Sloane is going all in on our ruby slip. I think
I have never seen pigment like this in a gloss in my life.
I know. We worked, the ruby slip was, it
that's
took the longest.
That's not sticky?
I'm not going to name it, but there's a certain red that we use that's really, really incredible. It's blue-based. What we did was we loaded it up with, again, jojoba oil, grapeseed oil, a polymer blend that we own that's killer. Also, because of the doe foot, the red that Sloane's putting on, she's putting it on without a lip liner. Yeah. She's putting it on just with the doe foot, and it goes right on. Again, it's like anyone can do it. And this is a red, I believe a red with like no makeup and a ponytail, like it's so classic. Anyone can wear red.
And my...
Oh my goodness, look at this!
Do you like it? Look at this!
I know.
I mean, normally when I go to take off a red, it's insane.
I know.
And my lips feel softer
right
after.
I know.
Where normally it's like this whole dried out experience.
If you do nothing else but use our lip scrub every day, and what I'm about to show you is our hero product. This is our lip slip. It is our company's number one bestseller to date. It is cashmere for your lips. And I said, what if we took out these 8 ingredients? What if we put in these 7 ingredients? And then what else can you and I come up with? And she said, I would get to use my chemistry degree for lips for the first time in the history of my job.
Sarah, that little tiny, tiny bit of sparkle, that's what gets me.
I want to touch on what has become our fastest selling product in the company. It's ridiculous. It is called the Dream Slip. It's night cream for your lips. You wear it while you dream. Smells like chamomile.
It's incredible. It's soothing.
Smells like a spa, which I do this at night.
I have a Pavlovian response to that where I know it's bedtime. Yeah.
It has become our fastest seller in our company's history.
Yeah.
Perfect lips, a little mascara, exfoliated face. Done.
Who needs anything else?
Who needs anything else?
I love it.
So we're just here to support. We're not here to take the place of anything. We're here to just support your lips and give you that perfect foundation. Just imagine putting any lip product on top of baby smooth skin. It's a game changer.
Hey. Thanks for teaching us how to never have dry lips again. Okay, take a second. Make sure that you are subscribed to the Sloane Series so you never miss an episode. Thank you so much. Make sure that you're following Sarah on Instagram.
Thank you.
I love you. Thanks. You do really fun lives.
I do fun lives. So we have at Sara Happ. That's our company. And then I'm at Sara Happ herself. So it's Sara Happ herself. That's the behind the scenes. That's my real life. That's me with my baby. That's me making product at home. And then Sara Happ is our company where that's the all your answers for lips on Sara Happ.
Oh. And leave any questions that you have for Sarah in the comments below.
Yep.
We're gonna go through.
I will answer any. I read all your comments. I read everything that you post or that you ask. I personally read it and I will personally respond.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. This was the funnest.